my hope. In the Lord is my help, is my shield and my strength, is my fortress I stand firm. I'm not fear.
My dear brothers and sisters, and I welcome you all to this Holy Eucharistic celebration, which is offered for the following intentions. Archdiocese of Hyderabad, Alwal Parish. This Mass is offered for Divyavani TV Corpus Fund donor, late Govind Rani, on her death anniversary, so that her soul may rest in peace. Offered by Govind Salomon, Chinnamma, Pasala Jyoti, Prashanti Vardhan, and family members. Today's Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, Word of God and Holy Hour also offered for this family and their intentions. And let us also remember and pray for all the donors of Divyavani TV in this Holy Mass. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today's readings invite us to make a decision either for God or against God. In life, every day we make knowingly or unknowingly so many decisions, but the biggest of all these decisions is that we make either for God or against God. And Jesus makes us understand the importance of making this decision in a beautiful way through a parable of two sons. One son who is good in words but not in deeds, while the other is not so good in words, but in action, in real life, is better than the first. And today, we need to check ourselves. Are we merely people of words or of actions? And for the times we have failed to be men of integrity, people who not only utter words in air, but follow them. Let us ask for God's forgiveness and mercy, because He is full of compassion. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who gave the priest Saint John of the Cross an outstanding dedication to perfect self-denial and love of the cross, Grant that by imitating him closely at all times, we may come to contemplate eternally your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
First reading, messianic salvation is promised to all of the poor. Zephaniah chapter 3 verses 1 and 2 and 9 to 13. A reading from the prophet of Zephaniah. Zephaniah chapter 3 verses 1 and 2, 9 to 13. Thus says the Lord, woe to her who is rebellious and defiled, the oppressing city. She listens to no voice. She accepts no correction. She does not trust in the Lord. She does not draw near to her God. For at that time I will change the speech of the peoples to a pure speech, that all of them may call upon the name of the Lord and serve him with one accord. From beyond the rivers of Kush, my worshippers, the daughter of my dispersed ones, shall bring my offering. On that day you shall not be put to shame because of the deeds by which you have rebelled against me. For then I will remove from your midst your proudly exultant ones, and you shall no longer be haughty in my holy mountain, but I will leave in your midst a people humble and lowly. They shall seek refuge in the name of the Lord, those who are left in Israel. They shall do no injustice and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouth a deceitful tongue. For they shall graze and lie down, and none shall make them afraid. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response will be, the lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
I will bless the Lord at all times. Praise of him is always in my mouth. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast. The humble shall hear and be glad. Your response?
The lowly one called, the Lord heard him.
Look toward him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This lowly one called, the Lord heard and rescued him from all his distress. Your response?
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
The Lord turns his face against the wicked, to destroy their remembrance from the earth. When the just cry out, the Lord hears and rescues them in all their distress. Your response will be?
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. Those whose spirit is crushed he will save. The Lord ransoms the soul of his servants. All who trust in him shall not be condemned. Your response?
The lowly one called, and the Lord heard him.
Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah to the
to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 21, verses from 28 to 32. Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew, chapter the 21st, verses from 28 to 32. At that time, Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What do you think? A man had two sons, and he went to the first and said, 'Son, go and work in the vineyard today.' And he answered, 'I will not.' But afterwards he changed his mind and went. And he went to the other son and said the same. And he answered, 'I go, sir, but did not go.' Which of the two did the will of his father?" They said, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Truly I say to you, the tax collectors and the prostitutes go into the kingdom of God before you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the prostitutes believed him. And even when you saw it, you did not afterwards change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, today in the Gospel, Jesus narrates a beautiful parable. A parable that tells us that it is not enough to call Lord and Lord 1,000 times a day and without doing his will. In the world, there are two kinds of people. The first kind, who are very devoted in words, who attend all the church practices, religious traditions, who pray a lot as well, who spend time with the Lord. But this is only at one level. But these people, when it comes to real practice of life, they are very, very far from what they do and say in the church. And there is second category of people who probably do not speak much about religion, who probably do not spend much time in the church or for religious practices. But these people practice charity. They practice kindness, and they treat other human beings with dignity and equality. And today Jesus opens our eyes and says, it is not enough to say prayers. It is not enough to talk about faith unless you put it into practice. These two categories of people are represented by the two sons in the parable that Jesus narrated today. The first son, when he was asked by his father to go and work in the vineyard, first he said, "I won't go." He was bad in words. But later he repented and he went. While the second son, he was good in words. When his father asked him to go and work in the vineyard, he said, "I will go," but he did not go.
And what is the message of this parable? The parable invites us that we need to make a final, ultimate decision. And this decision is a firm decision. And the choice we need to make is this. Either I am for God or I am against God. And this is the ultimate decision, and this decision directs all the actions, all that we do in our life. That's why Jesus asks, who is doing the will of God? Not the one who simply says in words but not put it into practice, but the one, even though his words were hurting to the Father, yet at the end he did what is pleasing to the Father. And more importantly, Jesus compares these people, one category of people, to the scribes and the Pharisees. He compares the son who said he will go, but who did not go. He compares them, compares this son to the Pharisees and the scribes. While he compares the so-called good son in practice to tax collectors and even the prostitutes, because even they believed John the Baptist and Jesus, but not the Pharisees and the scribes. And the word of God repeatedly, even in the Old Testament, it is inviting us, I am putting two ways before you. One that leads to God and life, and the other to Satan and death. You need to make a decision. And in life, every day, from morning until we sleep, until we go back to bed, our life is a series of decisions. Even to move a finger, we think it does automatically, but there is a decision of the brain even to move a particular finger or hand. In life, nothing goes without making a decision, but most of the times these decisions are made unconsciously. To move a hand, I don't make a big decision, but there is still this decision which is done unconsciously. And while we make hundreds and hundreds of decisions every day, this is the ultimate decision. Some people begin the race good. We have seen in Olympics, marathon races, people who go 40 kilometers, 50 kilometers running race, some people start it so good ahead of others, but slowly, they are tired and they don't finish the race. So Jesus tells us, it does not matter how you begin, but how you end. To the thief who was on his right, who asked Jesus, remember me in your kingdom, Jesus did not put before him all his wicked life in the past. Jesus said, today you will be with me in heaven. Because what matters to Jesus is not how we begin, but how we end our spiritual life. And many people, they begin their life good, morally, spiritually, but they end up by being on the wrong side. And today the church celebrates the feast of Saint John of the Cross, who did not live a long life, but then he got this title John of the Cross because of the crosses that he carried in his life. He spent many years in the lonely cave just talking to God and listening to him and sitting in silence. And the cross that he had to carry was so heavy because his own religious, his own people belonging to his own religious order, they imprisoned him for many months. Therefore, Saint John of the Cross sets an example for all of us. And he speaks about the dark night of the soul. What is the dark night of the soul? He says, most of the people, they have two paths, one right and the other left. One category of people, they pray to God just for earthly goods, like they need good health, they need a good job, they need money, and whatever this earth, this world offers us. And other kind of people, they desire for heavenly goods. Even heavenly goods, they are not God. But the only difference between the two categories is some people, they pray to God for earthly benefits while they are here. But others pray for heavenly benefit. But even the heavenly benefit is not good enough because that itself is not God. But in between these two paths, there is a very, very narrow, dark path. And people, very few people, experience this narrow dark path where you encounter God out of pure love. No matter how dark you are in and how painful your path is, this is a very, very narrow path, and it is in darkness that you encounter God. And Saint John of the Cross, he carried this cross throughout his life, as his name indicated, and sets an example before all of us that without cross, there is no glory. Without the Good Friday, there is no Easter Sunday. And without the cross, there is no Christianity, and there is no, our faith is of no use. Today, as we celebrate his feast, let us pray for the grace that we, no matter how big the crosses that we encounter, we may take them and receive them out of love and follow his example. Amen. Let's all stand and pray for our personal and the needs of the world and of the church. Lord, we pray for the Holy Catholic Church, for the Pope, the bishops, the priests, the nuns, and all the baptized laity, that we today on this feast of Saint John of the Cross, we may give witness to the world that without cross there is no salvation. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all the people that are offering this Mass and watching this Mass and praying for various needs, that the prayers in their hearts may be fulfilled if they are according to your will. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all the people who are infected and affected with COVID-19 in its various forms, that you may bring true and permanent healing of the bodies, minds, and spirits, that your spirit may enlighten the doctors, the scientists, and the entire world that is fighting to put an end to this pandemic. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a few moments, let's pray for our personal intentions. We make these prayers and the prayers in our hearts through Christ our Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, in commemoration of Saint John of the Cross, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now enact through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we to give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim,
Holy,
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 Holy
Lord.
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus Christ.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Antony, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Saint John of the Cross, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints we have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself to you only. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in Saint John of the Cross have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that, drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our holy mass is ended. Let us go in peace and joy of Christ to serve Him and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Wake up and stand for the Lord. Wake up, oh people, the Lord is very near. Wake up and stand for the Lord. Your craving Lord is near. Wake up, His glory will appear. Wake up, the hour of grace is near. That it never was. Wake up, O people, the Lord is very near. Wake up and stand for the Lord. Wake up, O people, the Lord is very near. Wake up and stand for the Lord.